I've taken your English teacher and turned your book to page number 67. We're going to read poem number 5, The Furry Home. Okay? This poem, in this poem, you will see a small child like you all, okay? A small child who imagines, okay? He imagines that if he became a mouse or if he turned into a mouse, how he wants to live. Okay? That is what this poem is all about. So we'll read the poem. First, I'll read the first four lines. Okay, if I were a mouse and wanted a house, I think I would choose my red new shoes. Okay, so here are the first four lines. This is, like I told you, a small child. Okay, he imagines it. He says, if I become a mouse, okay, then I would want to live in a house. If he wants to live in a house, then which one would he be choosing? He says, I think I would choose my new red shoes. Probably the child has received some red shoes here. You can see the red shoe here. Okay. So he says, I would choose the new red shoes to be his house. Okay. Furry edges, fur inside. What a lovely place to hide. Okay. So he says that the red shoes should have fur. Okay. It will be having fur not just outside but also inside as well, so that it would be soft for the mouse. Okay, so he says furry edges means the edge over here. This is the shoe, right? So the furry edges means this part. Okay, this is called as the furry edges, and not just the edges but also inside as well. Okay, so he says furry edges, fur inside. What a lovely place to hide. And when does a mouse hide? If someone is walking around or someone notices the mouse, even in our houses, if you find any small mouse, what does it do? As soon as it sees someone come, it goes and runs and hides, right? The same way he says, it's a lovely place to hide. Okay? I would not travel. I would not roam. Just sit in my furry home. So he says, I will not be traveling anywhere. I will not go anywhere because I'm very happy with the furry house that he's got. Okay, so he says that he's not going to travel or nor is he going to roam around. He just wants to sit inside the shoe and be happy. Okay, so yeah, it's a very small and simple poem. This is basically an imagination of a small child who imagines if he becomes a mouse, then he would like to stay in the red shoes, which has fur. Okay, fur, usually when it is cold, you feel it keeps you warm, right? Okay, so he imagines that he wants to live in his new red shoes, which has fur in it. Okay, so I'll read the poem once again. If I were a mouse and wanted a house, I think I would choose my new red shoes. Furry edges, fur inside, what a lovely place to hide. I would not travel, I would not roam, just sit in my furry home. Okay, so totally you have three paragraphs here. First one, he says, if I were a mouse, and you also have rhyming words given here. Okay, if you see the first four lines, if I were a mouse, okay. If I were a mouse and wanted a house, I think I would choose my new red shoes. Okay, the first four lines, if you see, mouse rhymes with house and choose rhymes with shoes. Okay, so here in the first four lines, you also find rhyming words also given in the poem. Okay, it's a very simple poem. Hope all of you all have understood it. I'll just read it once more and then I will ask you if you have any doubts. Okay, if I were a mouse and wanted a house, I think I would choose my new red shoes. Furry edges, fur inside, what a lovely place to hide. I would not travel, I would not roam, just sit in my furry home. Okay, hope all of you all have understood the poem. I see Aaron Joseph raising his hand. Yes, Aaron, do you have any doubts?
Understood, ma'am.
Okay, I guess. Yes, Ashwita.
What is page number, ma'am?
Page number 67. Okay, page number 67. Kindly note till you have your online classes. If the class begins at 10 o'clock, please log in at 10 so that you do not miss out anything. Okay, if you're going to log in even at 10, 5, 10, 6, 10, 7, this is such a small poem, it gets over very fast. Okay, you will be losing out. So when I tell you 10 o'clock the class starts, please be on time for the class. Okay, don't log in late. Okay, now I have read the poem. I've also explained. Does anyone have any doubt in this poem? Okay, very good. Okay. Okay, so for your essay one exam, you have till this poem. Okay, for your essay one exam, you have till this poem. I want you all to write the poem, The Furry Home, in your English classbook. Take a new page. Okay, take a new page, write today's date, write the heading, The Furry Home, and take down the poem. You have to learn this poem also by heart. Okay, it's a very simple poem. It is easy to by heart. Okay, children.
Oral, ma'am.
Okay, I want you to write the poem. Anyone has any doubt in this?
No, ma'am.
Everyone has understood, okay? Because if you have understood, then I will wind up with the class. Okay.